What's good, PB gang? It's your boy Poppy Blaster, aka Rope God.
Rope God. Rope God.
Yeah. And today I'm coming at y'all with something y'all been asking for a minute. You know what I'm saying? I did a video like this before. Of course, man. I mean, a lot of videos I'm gonna do is gonna be kind of like an update. You know what I'm saying? Version. Because, you know, y'all know, if y'all didn't know, I've been doing this for a long time. So, you know, after a while, kind of repeats itself a little bit, you feel me? But I always come up with something different. Plus, it's always new subscribers because my new subscribers maybe haven't saw it. So I always get recommended to do videos that I already did before, you feel me? But anyways, man, this video right here, if you haven't saw it or if you already know or whatever, it doesn't matter because it's gonna help you out anyways. It's the most important part of waving. What to do before and after you get a haircut, all right? So keep it locked. I'm so wavy, yes, I'm so wavy. Wave. So wavy, yes, I'm so wavy. Wave. So wavy, yes, I'm so wavy. Wave. I'm so wavy, yes, I'm so wavy. Wave. Okay, so before you get a haircut, you gotta prepare yourself to get, you know, you gotta prepare yourself. So, you know, of course she was woofing and all that, you feel me? You know, you looking for that crispy ass cut, you feel me? Like, no lie, you wanna see some progress, right? That's what we wait for, you know? We woof for it and all that to see progress. But when you woofing, you wanna make sure that you put in dumb work. You wanna make sure you brush it more than what you normally brush on a fresh cut or whatever. That's the most important part, to brush your hair when you woofing, because your hair is steadily growing and you trying to train it at longer lengths. So longer levels, you know what I'm saying? So if it's this long, nigga, you better be brushing using that hard brush like crazy. Use the hardest brush you have, you know, because you want to get to that first layer of hair, you know. So when you get a haircut, you will see progress, you know what I'm saying? Because sometimes people will be like, you'll be woofing a lot, and then you still be just using a medium brush. You're not getting down to that first layer of hair. So your hair might look, the top might be laid, you feel me? Like, okay, you know, you can see my definition and all this on top. Then when you get a haircut, you be having forks and shit that was all the way on the first layer of hair that you didn't see. You know what I mean? So make sure you brushing your hair a lot when you woofing, all right? Hard brush though. Another thing, before you go, you wanna prepare yourself. This is what I do. So 2 days before the haircut, 2 days before the haircut, all right? You do the wash and style method, all right? Wash and style method. I've been doing it with the African black soap, you know what I'm saying? You guys know about that, 100% natural black soap. If you haven't saw that video, I will leave it in the description box below. You guys can watch that video, it's important, okay? You should do that method before you get a haircut. 2 days prior from the haircut though, all right? So then, after you do the wash and style and all that, you know, you don't wanna put nothing heavy in your hair. So, cause you're preparing your hair for a haircut. So you don't wanna have a lot of, you know, product in your hair. You do not wanna have a lot of product in your hair. So I recommend that you just put like a light moisturizer in your hair. Or if you want to put a butter in your hair, just put a little bit and make sure it's a light butter, not a pomade or nothing like that, because it's going to be hard for your hair to get cut like that because it's going to be so greasy. You know what I'm saying? That product is going to be all into the guard, and it's not going to be, it's going to be harder for the guard to cut the hair. So I recommend you use a moisturizer or a light butter. I just use the moisturizer. You know, I use a moisturizer. You gotta moisturize your hair, because 2 days later, your hair is gonna be hella dry. You know what I'm saying? But if you throw the moisturizer in, the next day, your hair is still gonna be moisturized. But the next day, you can apply something else in your hair, like a sealing butter or a pomade or whatever, after the cut. You know what I'm saying? But if you choose to do it a day before the haircut, it's cool too. But I'll do it 2 days before. You know, just to prepare my hair, make sure that it's laid down, the progress be cool. So then 2 days later, my shit be ready, you know? So after that, you get the haircut. When you get your haircut, make sure that your barber do not cut your hair short. That's what I always tell you guys is, that shit is really important. Make sure he do not, or she do not, or you do not cut your hair short, bro. You know, it all depends on what type of hair texture you have, you know? If your hair is really trained, you know, you could go at 1.5 or 2 or whatever. You know what I'm saying? But I recommend to be on the safe side, especially if you're a beginner waver, to don't get nothing lower than a 2. If you're a coarser waver as well, don't go lower than a 2 with the grain, okay? Tell your barber to use a 2 guard, okay? With the leather either open or closed. No, closed would be a, yeah, two, even two. Open would be a 2.5, so it doesn't really matter, you know. To be on the safe side, have them leave the leather open first. And then check your shit, be like, look in the mirror and shit, okay, this is the length I like, barber, boom. He don't gotta cut it lower. Or if you feel like, you know, your hair is not even like, you're not satisfied with that, you feel like it's too long, have close the leather, go over it again, boom. It's gonna cut 0.5 of it more down, you know what I'm saying? So you have an even two, so it'll be straight like that, you know? So then the next step from there is, let's get the texture. So if you have, you know, more of a looser curl, you know, a looser curl, because I'm touch bases on my, you know, I'm not just for my course of waivers, y'all know I teach waivers at a period, you feel me? I don't care what type of hair texture you got. So if you got like a straighter curl, you know what I'm saying, bigger curls, straight hair waiver or whatever, the lowest you should go is, I say a 4 with the grain, no lower than that. You know what I'm saying? I don't want you to try to go with a 2 with the grain, because I'm telling you, corsair waivers to go 2 with the grain. Now you cut your progress out. For you guys, it's a 4. It's double that, because your curls are double bigger. You know what I'm saying? It's double the size of our curls. You know what I'm saying? So you be safe with the 4 with the grain. So, okay, so once you cut your hair, boom, you get that. We got that out the way. We prepared for the haircut. We got the haircut. Now it's time to let you guys know what you do after the haircut. Okay, after the haircut, bro, you go home. You're gonna have all type of loose hairs in your hair, right? Hella. Hairs on your chest, on your shirt and shit. You take your shirt off, get that off, boom. You know what I'm saying? All that off. After that, don't wash your hair, okay? Do not wash your hair. Don't. Wait about, about a week. Yeah, a week, okay? Even if you go to the gym and all that. So that's what I do, a week. You know, that's just to be on the safe side so that you will not lose your progress. Because to be honest with you, when you get a haircut right afterwards, everybody know this. You get a haircut right after your hair. You wash your hair right after the haircut, I'm trying to say. Then you're going to lose progress. It's going to, like, I don't know, something about, it's just the water and shit when you wash your hair, it just makes your hair look not even like more defined as if it looked when you first got the cut. So I recommend you don't wash it. Wait till about 5 to 7 days. Then wash your hair. Even if you go to the gym and all that, so what? Don't wash your hair. Keep it dirty a little bit. Oh well. Just wait. You feel me? You'll be straight. You're going to survive. Your hair be dirty a little bit. It doesn't matter. It's not going to do nothing. It's not going to damage your scalp. It's not going to do nothing. You'll be good. What you want to do, though, is brush your hair. You want to brush that shit out. You want to brush all the loose hairs out. Yeah. Brush it. If you choose to not brush it, you can use like I used to do this before. I don't do it no more, but I used to do it before, and it does work too. You know, you can use a hot towel or whatever on a fresh cut though. Even though I tell you guys not to wet your hair, you can a little bit on the fresh cut with the hot towel though. Just do the hot towel, rinse it out real good, and just rub it, just to get that loose hairs out. But I don't do it no more. I just brush that shit out. You feel me? Because I'm gonna get a good brush session anyway. So use a brush that you don't really care about, like, you don't really care about getting that hair in, because when you use that brush, all that loose hairs that was in your head from the haircut is gonna get inside your brush, trust me. So if you only got one brush, then use that brush and just wash it afterwards, and then when it dry, you can get your session in again. So you're gonna brush all that shit out, all right? Brush it out, and then after that, you're done, bro. After that, you're done, you throw your little pomade in, you throw whatever product you wanna throw in your hair, your royal butter, your royal thickener butter, whatever you put in your hair, your royal kingdom pomade, whatever you put in your hair, put it in your hair. Brush that shit in. That's what I use on a fresh cut. I always use royal avocado butter on fresh cuts. Royal avocado butter. If you want to purchase that, you already know what to do, man. The link is in the, actually, you can just email me at poppyblaster1@gmail.com if you want to get the royal butter. Royal butter, royal thickening butter, or royal avocado butter. I use any one of those after the haircut. It's great on fresh cuts, bro. It gives you that shine. It makes your waves pop more. All right. So that's all I do after the cut, bro. That's all I do after the cut. Like I said, you want to throw that sit-in in there, though, because, you know, before the cut and all that, 2 days prior, you washed your hair, you put a moisturizer in your hair. Now it's time to seal that shit in. You know, the moisturizer is still going to be in your hair. Now it's time to sit it in, and it's time to brush all that excess hair out. And you're good. That's all I do before and after the haircut. Simple. It's not hard. You know, everything, waving, it takes time. You know, like I said, it's a long journey. And it ain't going to happen overnight. Only thing that will happen overnight is a dream, bro. We're gonna make it come true though. We're gonna make those dreams come true. You already know what to do, man. But with that being said, I'm done with the video, man. I love y'all. And if you got any questions, you know, further questions, comment below. Y'all know I'll take care of y'all. That's what I'm here for. For the gang, PB gang, y'all know what it is, man. Love y'all. I'm out of here. Deuces.
Space coupe like E.T. It's the plug trying to call me. I was up chopping early in the morning. Ooh, on the wave like a durag. Pussy nigga calling for his boo bag. Plug walk Gucci on my shoe rack. Woke up in the house till I ran into the plug. Till I ran into the mud. I done